Welcome back to this already, the final segment of today's Price of Business. I'm your host, Kevin Price, talking about you and your business. As always, delighted to have my friend Lance Malone, and twice as delighted when I have him on twice in one day, which is the case today. Lance Malone's with a great company called Standard Supply, and great friend to the program. And I love his expertise and knowledge that he brings, and so I kind of let him carry these segments because he brings so much to him. And Lance, that's going to be the case this segment. Why don't you start off by introducing Standard Supply, introducing your guests, and then grabbing this interview by the horns.
Okay, Kevin, will do. Standard Supply is a distributor, and we sell heating, air conditioning, refrigeration, and ventilation products. And really what we do is we inventory products from all over the world so that the best contractors in Texas have the things they need to take care of their customers when they have a need in their home or business with their heating, cooling, ventilation, or refrigeration needs. And you can find out all about Standard Supply at ssdhvac.com. And I'm excited to have my good friend Hector Gomez here with me today. Hector is the owner of Freedom Heating and Air, LLC, here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. He's also a service consultant there. And you can find out about Hector's business at freedomcooling.com. That's freedomcooling.com. Hey, Hector, welcome to the program.
Hey, thank you for having me, Lance.
Hey, tell us a little bit about your background, how you got into the HVAC business, and then tell us about your company, Freedom Heating and Air.
Well, Lance, I appreciate the opportunity. First, I want to give honor where honor is due. I want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for this opportunity just to be able to come. It's an exciting time. Just excited for what the Lord is doing in my life. And my journey pretty much started in 2002. I took a path that, you know, I don't regret. But there's a learning experience that came out of it, which introduced me to the HVAC field. In 2002, I was honored to go work for a company doing new constructions. I didn't have no experience. I didn't even know how to use a hammer. That's all I knew. I mean, I didn't, you know. So basically, I went to work for this company. We did a lot of new construction, about 90% new construction. I picked up my experience there. It was all hands-on. And pretty much they trained me to be the detail man, which they gave me a punch list every day, and I had to drive around Dallas-Fort Worth up to Frisco sometimes just being able to take care of this punch list. So pretty much I worked there for over a year, and I really wanted to do more service. They did put me in the service department to do startups, and there were some things that were promised, and, you know, that didn't work out. So then I went seeking for another job, and I did find another opportunity at another company in 2003. And 2003, I went to work for this company. They hired me as a helper, which I didn't have a problem with it. I just believe that, you know, that was going to be a more learning experience for me, more hands-on. And I got my opportunity to go in as a helper. I learned so much. I always asked questions because I was hungry for what this trade had to offer, and I just wanted to know everything about it. And I did work as a helper with the lead installers, a couple of them, and then the opportunity came up where I was offered to become the next lead man, which I was excited about. So then working with this company, we would do a lot of new old construction, like commercial. I did some service work with the service techs, and that's really what I wanted to do was service. I like to be challenged. Mm-hmm. So I went there. I learned as much as I could, but then I also wanted to go to school, which this company wasn't able to help me, you know, with financially to send me to school. And that's really where my heart was at as well, is I wanted to go to school. So, you know, and I couldn't afford to go to school, to the trade school. So finally, I started seeking again after 2 years. In 2005, I actually got hired by one of the biggest companies here in Dallas-Fort Worth. And I got the opportunity to go to school there. And not only that, but to be a commercial service technician. And while being working there, one of the things that I've learned from them was how this company operated, why it was so successful, and the things that they would do. They would invest into our training. They believed in training, qualified, all the anything that was out there, new equipment coming out. They wanted us to learn the equipment. And again, being the person that I am, I wanted to be challenged, and I wanted everything that's out there. I took advantage of it.
So then how did that lead to you starting Freedom Heating and Air?
Well, working for this company here, I did go to trade school for 4 years here in CEF in Irving through North Lake College. And I pretty much went there. And in 2009, there was an opportunity for us to submit our paperwork to be able to see if we qualified to get our state contractor license. So I submitted my paperwork, got approved by the state. I took a prep course. And then I was able to take my exam, and I passed it. I got my refrigeration and my air conditioning license, which is an A endorsement with a combination. And I DBA'd as Freedom Heating and Air in January the 5th, 2010. Well, what happened then is I was already doing work for friends of friends, family members. You know, word gets out that you know somebody, a buddy of a buddy. And I started, you know, building my clientele there. But one thing that I realized that I was doing all this work here without having the license that the state requires.
Yeah, so that's a really good segue into something I wanted to talk about with you. I'm frequently asked by friends and family members about which contractor they should use. So how can a homeowner or someone who owns a business know that they're choosing a quality contractor to do their service and installation work?
I think what people look these days more is I would pretty much look for reviews online. We do get a lot of business through our Facebook friends and family. Word of mouth is pretty big for us. We're also involved with the Red Oak Chamber Board of Commerce there, so we get a lot of that relationship with our clients. Not only that, but I think when you're looking for a contractor, it's always good maybe to call some of their references, you know, if they can give you some references, because there is a lot of contract at their lands, and we ran across a lot of them where we're actually going behind them on some of the work that they do. And that's one of the things that, you know, yeah, you can go with the cheapest, you can go the cheapest way out, which who doesn't want to save a couple of $1,000s? But to me, those couple of thousands can end up being replacing your whole system or redoing everything again. Sure. And that's one of the challenges that we're facing in the industry right now, where you have guys that say, yeah, I can do it. But then is that really their license? Is it, or are they working under their friend's license, or are they a subcontractor of that other company?
Right. So yeah. How does somebody...
By the way, we'll quickly have to wrap it up. We're running out of time. We got about a minute and a half left, Lance.
Okay, Kevin. Hector, can you tell me how someone can find out whether a contractor has a license or not?
They can actually go to the Texas Department of License and Regulation.com there and look online. And actually, the number it should be on their business card, or it should be on their fender on their vehicle. They can type that number in, and then you'll be able to see if that license is either active or if it's current.
And also who it belongs to. Hey, thanks for being our guest, Hector. It's been my pleasure to have Hector Gomez, the owner of Freedom Heating and Air, LLC, as our guest today. And you can find out more about them at freedomcooling.com. You can find out more about my company, Standard Supply, at ssdhvac.com.
Thanks, gentlemen, and I encourage the listener to do just that, learn about both companies. Also, do want to remind listener that the best content here can be found over there at usdailyreview.com. Keep an eye out for that. And when we're back tomorrow, we're going to have much more for you. Do want to remind you the show does continue 24/7 at priceofbusiness.com. Have a great rest of your day and spend it wisely right here on this station.
Portions of today's Price of Business brought to you by CAOOY and Standard Supply.